But first, the big breaking story on the 6 p.m. news. Did Congress MP Vijay Dartha, who's now in the middle of the Colgate scam, make crores from coal block allocations? Well, NDTV has traced that money trail. Let's go right across to my colleague Srinivasan Jain for the details. This is the money trail in the coal blocks that were raided by the CBI. Vasu, what is it that you're hearing?
Right. Thanks very much indeed, Ankita. Well, so far, when the CBI has been raiding these companies on suspicion that they fudged figures about their net worth and that they were not worthy of being allotted coal blocks, the question mark was, on what basis then did they acquire these coal blocks and what did they do with them? What did they gain from sitting on this coal? Well, now NDTV has unearthed evidence which exposes the money trail in the case of one coal block allotted to a company called Jas Infra, and that directly shows you how the Dartha family, which has a stake in that coal block, could have benefited to the tune of a very large amount of money going up to almost 100 crores. Now, just to quickly run you through the entire sequence of events connected to Jas Infra, which, as we said, is a company that was raided by the CBI. Now, this company was set up by the Jaiswal Group of Nagpur, and the Dartha family had a 2% stake in it. Subsequently, the Dardas form another company. Now, this company called Asera Banka is entirely held by the Dardas. There is nobody else who has a holding in this company. This happens in 2010. Very soon after that, Jas Infra transfers almost 6 crores of its shares to this company, Asera Banka, at 10 rupees a share. And shortly after that, in fact, just I would say about 4 months ago, Asera Banka then sells 10% of its own shares to a number of mystery investors, for 113 crore rupees. They bought the shares from Jas Infra at 10 rupees a share, and they sold the shares of their own company, a company that has just been floated and which has absolutely no investments, no projects on the ground, for 8,800 crore rupees. And we have the documents here which establish that. And these are documents, mind you, that the company itself has formed at the Ministry of Company Affairs. And these are the documents of Asera Banka. If the camera can just zoom in, which shows you that shares, equity shares valued at 10 rupees, was sold for 8,885 rupees to a number of companies, which in turn, as I said, has led this company to acquire a profit of 110 crore rupees. Now, this, as I said, is a company that is owned entirely by the Dartha family. Vijay Dartha, in his declaration of assets to Parliament, has actually listed this company as one of those in which he's invested. And in fact, he says that he is a 70% stakeholder in Asera Banka Limited. And again, if I can just get the camera to zoom in, we can see there Asera Banka Power Private Limited, his ownership is of 74%. Now, we have actually spoken to sources in the Dartha family to try and understand from them what exactly is the basis of these transactions. And initially, they were extremely reluctant, but then one of them spoke to us on condition of concealing his identity to say that basically this company was set up to acquire 7% stake in Jas Infra, and that's why they floated this company. And in order to acquire that, they had to raise money from the market, and they sold these shares at a huge premium, which doesn't answer the question, who is it that would actually acquire such hugely overpriced shares at such a large premium from a company like Asera Banka, which, as we said, has no other asset or project on the ground? Who is doing the Dartha such a large favor? That's the question that will have to be answered. Remember also that Jas Infra is a company which itself has not started any projects. It's got a show cause notice from the coal ministry for no activity on its coal block. Its primary project in Banka in Bihar for a power plant has barely got off the ground. So this is an example, some would say, of how coal blocks, which are not translated into official projects, are being monetized, how people are cashing in on these coal blocks without the projects even having got off the ground. And in this case, it involves somebody who is part of a very powerful political family in Maharashtra. Let me now just go across quickly to my colleagues who've been tracking this story. First to Miloni Bhatt in Mumbai, Miloni. Now, you actually visited the offices of this company, Asera Banka. I believe you're coming to us live from the location of the office in Mumbai's Nariman Point. What did you find there?
Well, Vasu, absolutely interesting. We're going to pan the camera. We're going to show you Mittal Towers, beaming Mittal Towers, number 126. That's the office, supposedly, of Asera Banka Par Limited. So we went there, and what do we find when we go on the ground floor? On the nameplate is the name of Narendra Singh. What has he got to do with Asera Banka Par Limited? We went to the 12th floor, which is where the office is supposed to be, and on the 12th floor at number 126, which is where the Asera Banka Group have registered their offices, and those details are given in the registrar of company details, which they themselves have filed. We find a whole series of companies: Lokmat Group Private Limited, and of course this is the newspaper group which is owned by the Darda; Prithvi Prakashan Globe Advertising; Darda Investment; Darda Printocrats; Sound Factory. The list goes on. It's about one dozen names, but nowhere is Asera Banka Par mentioned anywhere. Absolutely. Now this is a bit staggering, because remember, as you said, Jacintra has transferred 5.8 lakh shares, value of 10 rupees each, to this company, which does not even have its name on the office that it claims to occupy in the details that it's given to the registrar of companies. Vasu.
India's number one news app just got even better. Download NDTV's new app, fully optimized for retina display, full screen view, faster response time, and Sudoku. NDTV's new iPad app. Download now.